Hello and welcome. You're watching The Logical Indian. I'm Shweta Kothari. We're talking about a very important story that's breaking today, and that is with respect to electoral bonds. So before I tell you the details of the story, let me quickly tell you what are electoral bonds. Electoral bonds are financial instruments through which you donate to a political party that you want. So as a citizen of this country, you can buy electoral bonds from rupees 2,000 to 1 crore onward, and you can then give these electoral bonds to a political party. The electoral bonds can then be redeemed by the political party. They're also transferable, so you can also give it to your friends, colleagues and family, and then they can donate to a political party they want. Now, the system was initially introduced in 2017. It was finally put into place in 2018. So when it was initially introduced, the idea was that this will bring in more transparency. The government of the day said that they don't want cash donations to political party, and hence bring in a system through which the money can be traced back. But remember, electoral bonds are secretive in nature because the confidentiality of the donor is maintained. So if you're donating, your details will be confidential and political parties will not know who's donating how much. Now, the latest story that is breaking is that in 2017, when the initial idea came into being, the RBI told the finance ministry that this is not a good idea, that the government should not do it because it's going to undermine the banking notes, the notes that we have in circulation, and also because these are transferable bonds, you will never know who's finally giving money to a political party. These concerns were obviously sidelined by the government, and the government went ahead with it. The bill was passed as a money bill. It's currently in the court of law. A larger bench is going to rule on whether it was right on government's part to bypass the Rajya Sabha and pass this as a money bill. But remember, in July of 2017, once again, the RBI wrote to the government saying that this is unprecedented. It has never happened anywhere in the world, and this would be wrong and it would be bad for the country. It also once again reiterated that since there is the system is opaque, that you don't know who's the final donor, it's not a good system. But the government anyway went ahead with it. Now, needless to say that this has led to political parties benefiting, because the BJP government, remember, in 2017 and 18 got 53% of its total revenue from unknown sources. It's not tough to then make out that these unknown sources could perhaps be electoral bonds. So the political party, the ruling dispensation, benefited from electoral bonds. It not just overruled the RBI, but it also bypassed the Rajya Sabha to bring in a system which today many people call as secretive channel of donation, because the identities of the donors are hidden. You cannot trace it back to the original source. But more importantly, the initial cap was to the tune of 20,000 rupees and above. That was later reduced to 2,000. So anybody essentially can now buy an electoral bond for a very small amount, and you never know whether that money is black or white. This is a damning revelation by a Huffington Post article, and the government is yet to come out and answer. Thanks very much for watching.